And now it's time for On the Money with your host, Dan White. Dan has been in the financial services industry for over 25 years, and he's been a featured expert in Forbes, Yahoo, the Philadelphia Business Journal, Dow Jones Market Watch, and has appeared nationally on Fox Business News. Dan is a member of some of the most prestigious financial organizations, including the Society of Financial Service Professionals and the National Association of Insurance and Financial Advisors. In addition, he's a chartered life underwriter and a chartered financial consultant. Credentials you can trust. Broadcasting from the heart of Wilmington, Delaware, here's your host of On the Money, Dan White.
It's not every day you hear a financial expert begin a broadcast by talking about the weather. But follow me here just for a second. Have you noticed our weather the last few years has been worse than usual? Whether you believe it's just cyclical or climate change, the weather forces have been a bit fiercer than in the last few years. And many weather forecasters and scientists say it's not going to get better anytime soon. And some of us talk about higher income taxes, like other people talk about the worsening weather. No matter where you fall on the climate change debate, I can tell you this. I think our income taxes are going to be getting worse. Welcome to the On the Money Show. My name is Dan White, and I am the host of your show. And this morning, we're going to discuss Roth conversions and the RMD problem. What's going on in the country? Where do we think taxes are going to be gone? And why Roth conversions might be a solution to that situation. Before we get into the program, though, we do have a couple announcements. We have a white paper today, and it's very timely with our subject. It's called The Partial Roth Conversion Strategy. It's a white paper that explores this strategy in detail, tells you what you need to know. And I'm a big advocate of the partial Roth conversions. I've done some myself. We've done them for a lot of clients. Those people that feel that taxes have got to go up in the future, and we're going to explain why today. So if you'd like to get a copy of the white paper, Partial Roth Conversion Strategy, pick up the phone and give us a call. Happy to send it out to you. You can reach us toll-free at 888-690-8820. Again, 888-690-8820 in Pennsylvania. It's a local call, 610-358-8942. 610-358-8942. We have four upcoming events this week. On Tuesday, October the 1st at 5:30 p.m., we're going to be at three different locations. We'll be at Cantwell's Tavern down in Odessa, Delaware. On the 1st at 5:30, we'll be out at Harry's Savoy Grill in North Wilmington. At 5:30, we'll also be at the University of Delaware Verdon Retreat Center in Lewis, Delaware, also at 5:30. So all three of those programs on Tuesday the 1st are today's retirement concerns and solutions. And then the next evening, Wednesday, October the 2nd at 5:30, we'll be at the Dueling Kurtz House out in Exton, PA, with the same presentation. So if you've got questions about your own retirement, when are you going to take Social Security? Are you going to take a lump sum? Are you going to take a pension? What type of pension option are you going to take? Where should you draw from? Should you do partial Roth conversions? These are all topics that we cover in these presentations. So if you want to find out more about these subjects, these are programs you don't want to miss. Pick up the phone and get a reservation as quickly as possible. All right, so now switching gears to today's topic. You've heard me talk about our federal budget deficit of $2 trillion per year. And like the weather, taxes are bad enough. And your tax concern is not because of the 2024 election or Congress, but because of what I call the RMD problem. One of the side effects of having some financial success and accumulating a comfortable amount in qualified retirement assets is the required minimum distributions, the RMD. Success has side effects. Your RMD percentage increases every year from the time they begin, and RMDs are taxable as ordinary income, as many of you well know. And one solution to this increasing tax increasing RMD problem is the Roth conversion. The Roth conversion offers several benefits to this RMD problem. A Roth conversion is taxable only at the time of conversion, and then it is never taxable again. Further growth in a Roth account is income tax free. So paying taxes now eliminates taxes on all the growth. Withdrawals and distributions from a Roth are income tax free, which can save you taxes in the future or for your beneficiaries. And you decide. You decide on your distributions, if any, because you are no longer subject to the IRS RMD schedule or increasing distribution percentage rates. Now, RMDs, if RMDs were not taxed as ordinary income, there would be no required minimum distributions. But because the federal government allowed before tax, tax-deferred retirement savings before retirement, they want to begin collecting income taxes in retirement. Indirectly, the RMD problem is kind of another longevity-driven problem. The longer you live, the greater your RMD percentage becomes. RMDs begin for the year that you turn age 73. For those born in 1960 or later, RMDs will begin in the year you turn age 75. And in addition, the IRS adjusted the RMD percentages downward 5% or 6% in 2022. So why worry? Well, at age 73, the RMD percentage is 3.8%. At age 80, the RMD is 5%. At age 90, the percentage is 8.2%. And suppose you live to age 100, your RMD will be 15.7% of the total value of your account. So basically what happens here is as you get older, the IRS takes the attitude, you know, you're getting closer to death. We're running out of time to tax you. We want more of your money. And the whole purpose of our discussion this morning, I was in Detroit earlier this week, and, you know, we were looking at the total deficit. And in 2007, the deficit was $7 trillion in 2007. In 2020, right before COVID, that deficit was north of $20 trillion. So we went up over $13 trillion. It took us 231 years as a country, you know, from 1776 to 2007 to rack up $7 trillion in debt. It took us another 13 years to add another $13 trillion. And then in the last 4 years alone, we've added $15 trillion to the national debt. So we got to figure taxes have to go up at some point. And that's the whole purpose for thinking about Roth conversions. At some point, these increasing annual percentages surpass your annual earnings and your total qualified retirement savings will begin to decline. The federal government and the IRS may well think that is as it should be. Unfortunately, many successful people really do not appreciate the IRS telling them what they should do with their money. They dislike the required part of the RMD. The distribution exposes the RMD to taxes, as we have said. There is no requirement that you spend the after-tax distributed amount. You can save that RMD again as non-qualified savings. But they want their money. They want you to take it out, pay the tax, then you can either save it, you can spend it. It's your choice. But if you have a $500,000 IRA at the age of 80, your RMD is going to be $25,000, and that is taxable with your other taxable income for the year. Everybody says, well, what's my tax bracket going to be? Well, it depends on your total income. What bracket are you going to fall into? I mean, you're going to add $25,000. As a result, increasing RMDs have the potential to push you up into a higher income tax bracket. you know, we were all brainwashed. Unfortunately, many people assumed or got brainwashed by the government that our taxes are going to be lower in retirement. That will not be the case if you have some money and or some income. You're not likely to be in a lower bracket in retirement. You know, we say that to people all the time. So how much are income taxes in retirement? The general answer is 10% to 20%, according to the Center for Retirement Research at Boston College. Their 2020 research brief divided the retired U.S. population into five quintile groups by income amount. The bottom three 20% quintiles paid from 0 to 2% in income taxes. So the bottom 20, the bottom 40, the bottom 60, they pay between 0 and 2% in total income taxes. The top 20% of retired Americans paid about 10 to over 20% if filing married or filing single. The top 5% of the top 1% pay taxes near and over 22% on average. More money pays more taxes, then taxes would still be a significant expense even in retirement. So again, this problem is not going to go away. You know, people feel that, oh, I'm retired, my taxes are going to be simple. I think, and you've heard me state this numerous times, that I think people have more tax flexibility, more tax planning can go on from the day a person retires to the day their retired minimum distributions kick in. This is the window of time you have to do Roth conversions, defer Social Security. You know, there's a lot of planning strategies from the day you retire to the day RMDs kick in. Let me give you our phone numbers. Toll-free, you can reach us at 888-690-8820. Again, 888-690-8820. In Pennsylvania, it's a local call, 610-358-8942, 610-358-8942. Today, we're talking about Roth conversions and the RMD problem that everybody's going to face at some point. We'll have more on this after the break.
When interest rates go down, you may refinance your mortgage. When interest rates go up like they are now, what do you do with your retirement planning? Have you considered refinancing or reevaluating your current retirement plan? We are now seeing historically high interest rates that can impact your retirement accounts in different ways. Learn how you can take advantage of these attractive rates and how you can seek to avoid the volatility that rising rates create. To learn more, go to danwhiteandassociates.com or call 888-690-8820.
Welcome back to the On the Money Show. My name is Dan White. I am the host of your show. This morning we've been talking about the RMD problem, and in particular, how can we solve that problem? By doing some partial Roth conversions. We talked a lot about that before the break, and we're going to continue with what the objectives are, how you go about doing it. We'll give you some real-life examples. But before we do have a couple announcements today. We do have a giveaway, and it's very timely. It's a white paper entitled The Partial Roth Conversion Strategy. So exactly what we're talking about today, if you think a partial Roth conversion makes sense in your planning, then this is a must-have white paper. It'll go into the ins and outs, the nuts and the bolts of how we go about doing a partial Roth conversion. And we're going to talk a little bit further about that this morning. But if you'd like to get a copy of our white paper, pick up the phone and give us a call. You can reach us toll-free at 888-690-8820. Again, 888-690-8820. In Pennsylvania, it's a local call, 610-358-8942, 610-358-8942. We have four upcoming events this current week. We're at three locations on Tuesday the 1st. Then we have another presentation on Wednesday the 2nd. All presentations will be at 5:30 p.m. They start sharply at 5:30. So on Tuesday the 1st at 5:30, we'll be at Cantwell's Tavern down in Odessa, Delaware. We'll be at Harry's Savoy Grill up on Naaman's Road in North Wilmington. And we'll be down in Lewis, Delaware, at the University of Delaware Verdon Retreat Center in Lewis, Delaware. And then on Wednesday the 2nd, at 5:30, we'll be at the Dueling Kurtz House out in Exton, PA. So I think we've got the area pretty covered. We're down in the Middletown, Odessa area. We're up in North Wilmington. We're in Lewis, and we're out in Exton. So If you'd like to get a reservation to one of these upcoming events, don't hesitate. Pick up the phone and give us a call as quickly as possible. All right, so now back to our subject at hand, and that's Roth conversions and the RMD problem. The first objective of a Roth conversion is to reduce total income taxes over time. The second objective is to reduce the amount of required minimum distributions. And other Roth conversion objectives may be income tax diversification, where a tax-free source of income is available as desired year by year. Also, many consider a Roth account to be an excellent legacy asset to leave to a beneficiary because it is income tax-free. Now, I will say, if you die with a Roth account and leave it to a child, you know, it's not a lifetime income. We know the Secure Act took that away. It's now a 10-year rule. But that being said, you can let the money continue to grow tax-free for the entire 10 years and then withdraw the whole thing tax-free. So it's not a bad thing. It'd just be nice if we could take it over a life expectancy. And because any Roth conversion is taxable income in the year of conversion, we're going to want to know the client's adjusted gross income and tax filing status. Ideally, we could look at the most recent two-page form 1040. We want to be able to estimate what the tax cost of the conversion will be. If we know the cost, we can determine an appropriate amount of conversion in the current tax year. Again, filling the bucket is the strategy we all try to implement. The fundamental tax planning idea is that taxable income spread over multiple years and tax returns will result in lower income taxes paid. This is because realizing all the income in one income tax year will push the client into a higher bracket, even possibly the highest tax bracket. A person may have a reason to do one large Roth conversion, but that would be uncommon and would not be done for tax reasons. And I'll tell you what, you know, the Tax Cuts and Jobs Act expires the end of next year. So if you haven't done anything, you know, you got to look at it. You got this year and you got next year and you got 2 years in this window and tax rates are going to go up. So, I mean, you might do one. But the other thing to consider, if you do a really large Roth conversion and you're 65 or older, it's going to affect your Medicare Part B and Part D premium. If you go above those Medicare premium limits, you're going to pay the surcharge on your Medicare Part B and Part D. But let's give you an example. Suppose a married couple has $75,000 of taxable income after subtracting their standard deduction amount. Standard deduction's around $30,000. The top of their 12% tax bracket is about $94,000. So they could convert $19,000 at a 12% federal tax rate. So they already took their standard deduction, they're down to $94,000. So they could do $19,000. That's not much of a conversion, though. The top of the 22% married filing jointly bracket is about $200,000, and the top of the 24% bracket is about $380,000. So subtract the $75,000 of other income, up to $305,000 could be converted from IRA to Roth at a maximum rate of 24%. Many taxpayers will do partial Roth conversions and pay income taxes at 22% and 24% rates and really try to avoid the higher 32 to 37% rate brackets. A Roth conversion has the potential to achieve several important objectives for a single or married client. Each situation is individually different, and so is their tax return. Perhaps it would be helpful to do a snapshot of a conversion. Look at your last year Form 1040 tax return. Page 1, line 15 shows your taxable income. For conversion snapshot purposes, add $100,000 to that number and calculate the income tax on that amount. Look at the single or married joint brackets and do the simple arithmetic. Is that too much to convert based on the tax cost Or do you want to convert more than that? What will future income tax rates be? That's always an important tax question, and more so now. You might think of this as two black and white situations. If you knew future tax rates would be half of the current rates, 50% less than today, you would not do any Roth conversions now. You would wait for 50% lower rates and convert at that time. But if you knew future tax rates would be double the current rates, 100% more than today, how much Roth conversion would you do? Would you do 25%? Would you do 50%? Would you do even more? You would convert as much as you wanted or could afford now before future tax rates increase so much. You know, we go over tax levels in our programs. The highest tax bracket in history was right around World War II. It was about 94%. Throughout the 70s, the highest bracket was 70%. So if you think rates are bad now, they could get a lot worse. And I think future income tax rates are likely to increase for those with assets and incomes. The cost of government today is greater than ever. And the federal deficit and our national debt both seem incredibly large to me. Those with assets and incomes are the people who have this RMD problem and are most likely to benefit from Roth conversions. Our current presidential candidates want to either lower taxes and they want to raise taxes and tariffs. That doesn't mean they can do what they want or even will do what they promise. We should bet the over. Income taxes are more likely going up for those with an RMD problem. And if a person wants to do Roth conversions, 2024 and 2025 should be good years in which to convert IRA money to Roth money and pay the tax. A person could do Roth conversions in two chunks, then probably save some taxes and certainly reduce their future RMDs. Now, what money do you use to pay the income taxes on your conversions? Ideally, you would have non-qualified funds somewhere, maybe something like a bond fund or a money market fund or a mutual fund that you can use to pay the tax on the Roth conversions. Otherwise, people do pay the Roth conversion taxes using their qualified funds. But if you want or need to use qualified retirement funds to pay conversion income taxes, you will need to allow for that in your conversion calculation. Instead, you should determine your total taxable distribution, the combined conversion amount, and the amount you need to take out to pay the taxes. So if you want to convert $200,000 of IRA to Roth and your top bracket will be 24%, you put 24% of your IRA in a money market fund now and convert the remaining 76% to Roth now. It's that simple. You do it this way so as not to do your conversion first, then realize you need to make another IRA withdrawal to pay the taxes, which would be another taxable distribution. And I like doing Roth conversions in the fourth quarter of the year. It's easier to estimate your current year's taxes then. Also, you want to file and pay an estimated income tax payment by January 15th of the following year, 2025. And that is close to the time you file your Form 1040 return for 2024. Also, for those doing partial Roth conversions over several years or more than using a fixed indexed annuity or fixed interest annuity, you can do a larger IRA rollover into one annuity and convert internally smaller amounts of that annuity over time with a simple form. This preserves the initial annuity and does not require a funds transfer. Your annuity, it would basically have two pockets, an IRA pocket and a Roth pocket, and you move funds back and forth from one to the other. Let me give you our phone numbers. Toll-free, you can reach us at 888-690-8820. Again, 888-690-8820. In Pennsylvania, it's a local call, 610-358-8942, 610-358-8942. The Roth conversion is a useful strategy for those who want to do something about it. We stay out of the weather prediction business, and we'll leave that up to legislators and scientists to figure out. But if you need help with your retirement planning, give us a call. Have a great week.
The views and opinions expressed on this program are those of their respective parties and not those of this show's producers or this station. Join us again for more.